We're all set.
Okay. Anyways, you've been on the road since January. How are things going on the tour?
We've gone from being popular and happening to being suddenly, you know, larger than life. And we decided that it was time to really break the United States. You know, we wanted to end up on the US Festival.
For the US Festival in 1983, I wanted all people of all music types to find kind of their days in this event. And I love good heavy metal music, and I even understand how they're somehow relating to other human beings in playing it. But I didn't realize how incredible our heavy metal day was going to be.
Over 300,000 people just getting along, having a good time, no trouble. It's California, it's where it's at.
I think the event is bigger than any one band. You know, there's so many fans, 200,000 or 300,000 people out there. Some of them are here to see us, some of them are here seriously Van Halen, but more than that, they're here for the event. It's a gathering of people.
I remember flying in over the S Festival, and it was an amazing adrenaline rush. I can only imagine what it was like for those guys. That was the biggest venue they've ever played.
I'm sitting in the helicopter, and we're going over these fields of all of these people. I was going, oh, shit.
What the fuck have we got ourselves into here?
There were so many people, the security and the throngs of press and media, and this was just a circus. I met Steve on the afternoon of the show, and we hit it off, and I said, why don't you introduce us when we go on stage? Have you introduced any bands? No. Would you introduce us? Oh, I'd love to. So we literally walk on stage together.
That was very rare, but I mean, I was glad to do it. I'm so glad now that I did it.
There's more to come. Here's one of the groups that really believed in this event, as we believe in them, Triumph.
I'd like to see some hands in the air. I want to see some Allied forces out there making a little bit of noise. You know what I'm talking about?
For the heavy metal day, it was mostly guys, and it was broiling hot, so they'd all taken their shirts off. So it was just pink flesh that went as far as you could see out and over the hills. It was surreal to be playing that gig.
US Festival in 83 can be looked at as one of the defining greatest moments in the history for hard rock and metal, and it was an incredibly important stage for Triumph to be on. Their inclusion sent a big message about how far they had come in their career at that point.
If you go down the list of the heavy metal day, Van Halen, Ozzy Osbourne, Judas Priest, Motley Crue, these are bands that look dangerous. And then here are these three guys from Canada who are on the same stage, but they're all in white. Rick Emmett sounds angelic, even Gil. And they looked like they went to boys choir school. So it situated Triumph as the good guys in an era that was meant for the dirtbags.
Here's what I want to do. I want to see everybody now putting your hands together like this.
Triumph was a well-oiled machine that day. The singing, the playing, everything. And you could tell they wanted perfection. And that was rare. I was definitely connected to this band because of Rick. It was kind of like if Eddie Van Halen was this lead singer, too.
I remember thinking, I gotta try and play this good because there's all these cameras here. They had them on arms, they had them on tracks. You couldn't escape them, they were everywhere. Sometimes I'm gonna run, and I'll look like a tiny little guy running all the way over in front of this giant PA, and it'll look a little goofy. So I thought, wow, there isn't a human within 100 yards, except the cameraman.
I remember watching this on TV, and I was like, this is incredible. And he was running around entertaining these couple hundred thousand people, playing perfectly.
Oh.
But then he sat down and entertained a couple million people, the people at home. And it was genius.
The US Festival represented a realization that we'd reached a point where our fans were unequivocal in their support.